The second box is a much more complicated than the first one. So we have in it, first of all, a tab widget, which has three tabs, and each of the tabs have different content. And below it, we have a button for running the actual query. So the first thing I'm going to do is drag a tab widget over to this group box. And the tab widget can also be found under containers because it's for storing other widgets. So I'm taking it and dragging it over and dropping it onto the second group box. And then I'm again changing the layout to vertical of that group box. As a result, the tab is now expanded. And we need a tab with actually three tabs, not just two, as is the default here in Qt Designer. So I'm doing a right click on the tabs at the top and picking the entry insert page to, and then it doesn't really matter whether it's after or before. And then we have a tab widget now with three tabs. As I said, it's important that we name objects correctly so that they match the code that we will later show. And this tab widget, I'm going to show that, but I'm not going to show it for many more. So this tab widget needs to be called query services TW for tab widget. And the individual tabs that you now see below it, that's why I'm showing it here, also need to be renamed. I'm doing that directly here in the hierarchy by double clicking the name there. And then the first one needs to be named Nominatum tab because it's the one that has the content for querying Nominatum. The second one should be named GeoNames tab. And the third one should be named Direct Input tab. So this is just to demonstrate how you would name the objects for the individual tabs accordingly to what the labels you see in the image. We still also have to change the titles of the individual tabs to say OS Nominatum, GeoNames, and Direct Input. For that, we have to go into the property editor. So I have the first tab selected right now, and now I'm scrolling down in the property list to the green area, which are the properties that are specific for this for a tab widget. And there, it currently says tab 1 for the current tab text. And that's what I'm going to change to the OSM Nominatum. And I'm doing the same thing for the second tab. This one should have the title GeoNames, and the third one where the title should be Direct Input. Okay. Then in addition to this tab, we have the button at the bottom for actually running the query. I could directly add the button at the below the tab widget into the group box widget, but then it would expand horizontally to fill the entire window. If I just wanted left aligned like this here, I'm first going to add a horizontal layout. So the layouts are right at the top of the list of widgets. So I'm taking that and dragging it to the area below the tab widget, but still directly below it so that it's still part of the group box. So now I've added the horizontal layout here. And now I'm going to add the push button widget, which you can find under buttons, dragging it over. It's actually in this case easier to drag it onto the horizontal layout we just created here in the hierarchy. And now we have the push button as part of the horizontal layout. And now we can, to make it just a small button on the left, add a horizontal spacer, which is here in the Qt widget list under horizontal under spacers, and add that to the right of the button into the horizontal layout. I have to really aim carefully to like this. And now you see that the spacer expands as much as the other widgets allow, and as a result, the push button is shrinked to just take a bit of space to just show the label completely on the left. And we can now change the title of that button by double-clicking it and then entering run query. And now we have the core structure of our second group box done, but we still need to set up the content of the three different tabs. So I'm selecting the first tab now, the one for OSM Nominatum. And when looking at the actual tool, we see that the content of this tab consists of two edit fields, line edit fields, two labels for them, and one checkbox for enabling or disabling the country code input field. These are arranged in a grid layout. So we have a first column with just a checkbox, a second column with the labels, and a third column with the line edit fields. So I'm going to start with the checkbox under buttons here. So I'm dragging that one onto the empty area of the OSM Nominatum tab. Right click into the empty area and pick a grid layout. And I'm going to double click the checkbox to clear out the text. So there should be no text for that checkbox. And then we would still have to change the object name using right click object name. The next thing is I'm going to add the label. Labels are very close to the bottom under display widgets. I'm pulling it to the right side so that you get a vertical bar. It means I'm going to add the label in the cell that is to the right of the cell containing the checkbox. And then let me also add the second label. This one should be below. And then I'm going to add the two line edit fields by dragging them over and placing them again to the right. So that was the first one, and we can have the second one. And now you see that we already have the correct layout that we wanted. I double click the first label to change its text to say country code column and do the same thing with the second label to change the title to say limit. And I'm in the second field, I'm already going to enter the value 10 as a default value that will be always there, even without the user having entered anything into the field. And then we are done with the first of our tabs, and we can move on to the GeoNames tab. The GeoNames tab, again, uses a grid layout, but it has a few more widgets. It has actually four line edit fields. Let me start again by, let me start with the label for GeoNames username. So I'm dragging it onto the empty area of the tab and changing the title to GeoNames username. Then I'm going to change the layout to a grid. Again, doing right click, layout, layout in a grid. Well, let me first add all the labels. So I'm adding a second label below the first, and a third, and a fourth one. And the second one I call country code. The third one, feature class. and the fourth one limit. Now let's add the two checkboxes for the second and third row to the left of the labels. So I'm dragging the first checkbox over until the blue bar appears vertically to the left. So and then I'm clearing the text again so that we have just the checkbox. And I'm doing the same as the second checkbox. And now it's time to add the four edit fields. So these are again line edit widgets. I'm dragging the first one to the right of the first label. Then second one, now you see that it actually shows the shell, the cells as red boxes. So, and the third one and the fourth one. So now we have exactly the layout we have in the actual tool. And I'm again entering a default value of 10 for the last line edit field for the limit. And that means we can move on to the third tab for directly adding, entering feature information for a single feature. Again, same procedure, we're using a grid layout. I'm first going to add three labels, one below the other, changing the layout to grid. The first label gets the title name, the second label the title latitude, and the fourth label the title longitude. And now the corresponding three edit fields. The first one to the right of the name label, second one in the cell below, and the third one again in the cell below. And that's it. We are done with the service group box and can move on now to the next group box for displaying the results.